What's up, everybody? Welcome to Gamingtech. Some of you gonna remember this case that I did a build for a friend. Well, there's a reason I have the system back, because he did end up messing his computer very, very badly. From corrupted Windows files to the way he turned off his computer without doing it from the software, just cutting with the electric. Somehow, stuff happens, as you guys know. In this video, I will be fixing these problems, take a look at what's wrong with the system internally and externally. He also mentioned that he failed installing Windows, which I did guide him through, but he couldn't get internet. The main reason for that is network adapter being missing. I suspect that he downloaded Windows 11 files, even though the system is Windows 10, because of the USB stick that I gave him. So you need to have right files in order to make it work, which is Windows 10 in this case. Don't mind the cables, because the idea is just me to fix this computer and give it to him as soon as possible. I removed the CMOS battery in case he went into the BIOS, which I forgot to film. We booted the system. Hopefully we get into the Windows. Okay, as you guys see, this is how it looks after you've done your installation. As you see, it's the normal Windows 10 running here, with service packs and drivers being not installed yet. You can tell from the screensaver as well. Immediately I saw that the network adapter is missing here. By installing this, we're gonna fix his internet problem instantly. You have two separate files for this MSI motherboard. Network adapter is for the LAN, and for Wi-Fi there is a separate one if you wish to use. As you see, I have my SSD on top of the case, which is 80GB SSD from Intel back in day. It costed like 350 euro, I believe, and it still works. As you see, we have internet now officially, which is gonna help me updating the rest of the system.
Nice.
Now we're in Windows update. We will be updating all of the required drivers afterwards. That way we will be able to update to Windows 11. It takes time. The bad thing about this is the system was functioning perfectly, but once you lack some knowledge in certain areas, you can end up doing mistakes that's gonna cost all of your files and everything else. Luckily, he had just games in this computer, so it wasn't a big issue, but I will not be installing the games for him. That'll be a small punishment so he learns and to respect his machine much more. This procedure takes some time, which is completely normal. One thing I noticed, tempered glass was completely loose, so he is extremely lucky that the glass itself didn't break. In fact, one of the screws just came out. Do you see that? I was shocked. That's a brave guy coming with this case like that. Another thing, once I installed MSI Afterburner, I noticed that the RTX 3050 wasn't being detected, for reason that being is, as you see, the cable is not quite connected properly. Unless you don't know what you're doing, do not touch the system. Make sure that there is no hesitation. Let's boot the system. The card is gonna spin, afterwards stop, which is completely normal. Hard drive wasn't being detected. So we create a new partition. Sometimes this happens with brand new hard drives for some reason. Very easy to fix. I just left it as a new volume so he can always go back and rename it. I will be giving him the instructions how to do it as well. Can you mess another thing here? Yes, if you wish to wipe the system by just pressing format. Let's take a look at the inside of the system with the dust levels. Yep. It shouldn't be looking like this unless you care about your system. I recommend cleaning it at least once a month. If you're lazy, every 6 months. But this is such a compact system. Here I'm using a vacuum cleaner. I believe the brand is Parkside. It has a function that it blows also. 200 watt is very powerful. You saw how the dust particles were flying everywhere. Stuff like this I recommend you to do outside. Since I'm in an office environment and my door being open and wearing a mask, no problem. Let's remove the front panel. Just push it on this AeroCool case. You push it towards yourself. The fan blades were dusty, so I had to individually clean them with a wet wipe. Underneath power supply will be dusty as well. Checking the mesh. When you have the required tools, it's very easy to do this procedure. Afterwards, I will be cleaning the tempered glass and all of the problems are basically fixed. So what did we do? We fixed the windows. We fixed the network adapter. We introduced the hard drive to the system. I had to go through the registry files. 300 files were manipulated heavily. Possible to torrent stuff, you name it. But it's fixed. So system is running nicely. He can update his games and install his stuff as he wishes. And never cut the electric the way he's been doing. Always through the software. Or at least the power button. If there's something wrong. But do not do, oh, my system is laggy, let me just cut the electric. The reason for system being laggy, he ended up installing stuff that shouldn't be there, taking the resource of the processor basically. This tool is amazing. From Bosch GlassVac. If you guys have any questions, comment below, like and share the video. Thank you for your support. Rest of the footage is gonna be about just me cleaning the system. So if you wanna watch it, go for it. I'll see you on the next video. Take care of yourselves. Let's go, guys. And take care of your systems. I'm sure he will be watching this and taking many advices from this.